at Willie Street, there's a mural called Try a Little Tenderness. It is an homage to Otis Redding. So the whole thing about that first mural is that I had two friends wanting to come to Wisconsin to visit the Hamilton Woodtype and Printing Museum.
Okay.
And I was like, if you have a chance to come, please stay in Madison, stay here for a week, let's do stuff in here, and then we go together to that conference, the Ways Goose Conference in the beginning of November. So as we were exchanging ideas and in about when they could come here and etc., I just told them, would you like to do a mural here in Madison? Because they have done murals before with their collective group called Creatipo, the artist group.
Okay.
And they were, and they told me, well, if you can get us the wall and the paint, we'll do it. And I was like, challenge accepted. And then I had like 40 days to figure things out. So I reach out to the city. I was looking for someone to talk to, and they told me, you got to talk to Karen Wolf. Karen Wolf is the person, and she was of great help because she helped me cut through all the red tape. She pointed me to a grant, and she drove me around to look for walls. So it was like we managed to make that happen because I was like, my friends are coming on the first week of November. If we can get this ready, they would paint a mural, and then it worked. And then I told them about doing an homage to Otis Redding, which I'm a big fan, and I didn't know he died here in Madison until
Okay.
No, because I mean, I was a fan, but I never researched his history. And then once I got here, I was just walking at Monona Terrace and I stumbled upon the plate. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, so he died here. So I always felt like there should be some more uplifting connection with him in town. And then my friends were on board to pay this homage to him through the mural. We talked about Try a Little Tenderness. So ultimately, that mural was designed by Jackson and Sila Costa, my friends, and I was more like producing the mural and documenting the process. I made a making of video that is online showing the process mm-hmm. of the mural during that week. And it was an amazing experience. And I got to know so many great people because of that project. And that led me to the second one, which is the Better Together mural in the Madison Mural Alley behind the Hawthorne Library.
Yeah.
And for that mural, I invited two other friends. I always find a great thing, like a great excuse to invite friends to do art stuff. So I invited two other Brazilian friends, Flavia Zimbardi and Caetano Calomino. They were living in Brooklyn at the time, and they came here to do that big mural. And it was also an amazing experience, especially because we had some a really frustrating issue with the mural, which was they got here on a Wednesday, and they decided to go straight to the site and start tracing the letters. It had this Better Together, huge lettering. And Caetano was tracing with chalk the letters using levels and rulers, paper rulers. And Flavia was just telling him the measurements. Like, you go 30 in here, 60 up there. And he was like measuring. Between Wednesday and Thursday morning, he had traced like 95% of the mural. He was like, and we had painted the wall first and etc. So he was like ready to go. We went to lunch. It was amazing. And like afternoon, okay, let's start, finish the tracing and start painting. And then a tropical thunderstorm.
Oh, geez.
It washed away everything.
Oh, no.
Like it was raining and raining. When we come outside, it was gone. We were like, no way. And then,
I mean,
and
I knew you were going to say that, but I was hoping it was going to be something else.
Nothing. Like it was raining horizontally to the wall, and then it washed away everything. Mm. Like 2 days of work of tracing. And then we learned from that. And then the next day we were like tracing, painting. Like, it didn't wait too long to start painting. But like it was such a challenge. But ultimately it was a fantastic solution. And I'm really proud of that Madison Mural Alley to see the work of different artists in one place. It revigorated the area so much.
Yeah.
So it's like it is beautiful.